Hey guys, and welcome back to a very special video on the Tom of the Man channel. Why is it special, I hear you asking? Well, no, it's not just because it's Friday. No, it's not because I've had a haircut. And no, it's not because leads are getting promoted. It's because I am going to be in my element today. My element, I hear you ask once more, is eating food. You don't get a body like this without trying. This is 25 years of hard work and perseverance. And you see people going to the gym to work for a six pack. I go to the kebab shop to work for this. So today we're going to be doing the first episode of Tomo Tries, a new series on my channel. I'm going to try various food products, or it might not be food, but it's most likely going to be food. Look at me. Also, I want to point out I have been streaming on Twitch, just a few streams on twitch.tv/tomandtheman94. Just we've been playing with the boys. However, I'm going to try a bit harder with that. I really enjoy streaming and the interaction with the chat. So pop over there. I'll leave a link in the description. Go give me a follow. So, as you've seen from the title, today we're going to be reviewing the new Walker's Taste Icon Crisps. These aren't actually that new, they've been out around 3 months. However, because of lockdown, some of you might have not been able to pick them up. I'm going to give you a thorough review of these. So most people would just review taste on a crisp. I'm going to review the packaging, the texture, the taste, the aftertaste, and the crisp experience. So most people would try these straight out of the packet for the first time. I've been living with these for around a week. I bought the five sets of the five multi-packs and I've eaten four packs so far just to get a feel for if I'm enjoying the crisp long term, if I want to eat the crisp over a long period of time, and if the crisp makes me want to go back for more. So if I'm just sat working at my desk, I think, I really want a packet of Gourmet Burger Kitchen Classic Cheeseburger Crisps. That's a good score for them. Each will be scored out of five, and at the end I'll come up with a winner, and that winner will take the place as my crisp that I'll eat each day next week. So a big prize. That's three or four bags of crisps a day for each one, so that's big sales for whoever wins that. So we have the five crisps here. They are from Gourmet Burger Kitchen, Yo Sushi, Pizza Express, Nando's, and the final one that I found it harder to get hold of is the Las Iguanas Chili Con Carne. We're gonna get straight into it in the line here. As I say, I have eaten them all before, and they are all Walker's crisps. I like the texture of Walker's crisps. It has enough bite so that your grandma can't just gum her way through it. However, it's not too crunchy that the caffeine addicts amongst us with sensitive teeth have pain every time we try and bite through it like a stick of Blackpool Rock. First things first, you'll get a lot of nice rustles in the video. We have the Gourmet Burger Kitchen Classic Cheeseburger Crisp. Packaging is fairly plain. There isn't really anything that suggests this is kind of a cheeseburger. I mean, it's yellow, but it's very similar packaging to the cheddar cheese crisps that Walker's already do. Kind of a plain coloration, maybe a two on the packaging. Doesn't really shout out that I want to eat these crisps, so let's open the packaging a little bit. Let's see what we get here. Not the best of pulls. We'll dig one out. Slightly misshapen. Coloration on the crisp is quite nice. Smells good. Getting onion and pickle a lot through there. And let's take our first bite. Got that classic Walker's texture. And yes, most of the flavour is pickle and onion, which is good, because otherwise these could just taste like a cheese crisp. However, they're not as oniony as a pickled onion crisp, or as pickly as a pickled onion crisp, but that is sort of the key flavour. There's no real meat flavour, there's no real cheese flavour. It's kind of a dulled down pickle, and for that I'm going to give the taste a 3. It's not an unpleasant crisp. I would happily eat bags and bags of these, but it doesn't stand out to me as one where I think, oh yeah, they taste amazing. Aftertaste, slightly oniony again, but not too powerful. I actually quite like this in aftertaste, however, I'm a big fan of onions. So I'll give the aftertaste a 3.5, definitely not bad. The crisp experience. Now the crisp experience, it's just a standard crisp. There's nothing shouting out at me about these. It's not a bad crisp, I wouldn't avoid it, but I also wouldn't go out of my way to go downstairs and get a pack during the day. I'd probably give it a 2.5 for the crisp experience. It's a very middle of the road crisp. Okay, on to packet number 2. Here we have the Pizza Express American Hot Pizza flavour crisps. So interesting that they haven't gone just for a margarita flavour crisp, they've also brought in this American Hot, which is a signature pizza they do. Pizza Express is obviously a favourite jaunt of Prince Andrew, so by royal appointment, these should be some of the best crisps around. Let's get into the packaging. I actually like these. I like darker packaging on a crisp. You don't get too many with Walkers. They had the barbecue rib, which is a lot harder to find these days. And the contrast between the crisp and the packaging makes it stand out a lot more. It's also slightly off black, which is nice. They put a bit of thought into that. And it makes the crisps look a lot more appetizing. So as we see here on the GBK ones, it just looks like a crisp. That could be a Google Image crisp. This one you can clearly see some spice in the flavouring, looks like a little bit of oregano on there, maybe a bit of basil. So these definitely standing out to me so far in terms of packaging. I'm going to give them a 4 on the packaging and just confirm they have a nice pull. Oh yeah, that was quite a satisfying rip. So let's have a smell. I mean, it's a dead smell. There's a little bit of tomato, a little bit of oregano or something in there, but they're not really standing out at all. However, I do think they look nicer crisp. The seasoning on them at least makes you think they'll taste of something, even if they don't. Let's take a bite. It's that classic Walker's texture. As good as we know, then you get quite a hit of flavour to start with. It feels like they've just been dusted with flavour, and then the flavour slowly drifts away. They do have a nice little spicy aftertaste to them though, and they aren't lacking in flavour. There is definitely something there. It just isn't an expanded flavour. So I'm going to score them 3 on the taste and 4 on the aftertaste, because I quite like that little bit of spice. Makes you know that you've eaten something. The crisp experience. Now these are the only crisp here, I think, that is going to make you put the toilet paper in the fridge for the next day. And because of that, it gets a +1 on the score. I like that, it's extracurricular activity. Again though, these have been sat on the shelf for a little while and I've not thought of them, I really wish I could eat those. I'm going to give them a 2.5 again for the crisp experience. Third up, we have Las Iguanas Chili Con Carne. These are a little bit harder to find. I don't know if that's because they're less popular or just because that's not what was stocked at the time. Packaging wise, so pink is a classic crisp packaging colour, and Prawn Cocktail is a great flavour of Walker's crisps. Would I be disappointed if I saw the side of this and thought I was getting Prawn Cocktail and ended up with these? Probably. Again, the crisps here don't look that great. I think with Chili Con Carne, they could have done something better with the packaging here. Pink doesn't really scream Chili Con Carne to me, but yeah, the packaging I'd say is a 2 on these. Let's give them a nice stir. Good pull. The smell, so they do smell like Chili Con Carne, which is good, true to smell. Yeah, definitely. That's a nice shaped crisp, but it isn't screaming eat me. Good bite. You can't complain with these crisps. They taste like Chili Con Carne. Why has no one made a Chili Con Carne crisp before? They maybe don't really suit being crisps. It's a nice crisp, and I would eat many packs of these. I'd give taste 4. Aftertaste, would hope for maybe a little bit more spice. I'm going to give them a 3. However, these are certainly a very nice crisp. I would happily eat these over the other two, I'd say. So I'm going to give the crisp experience 3.5, just because throughout this week, I've probably wanted to eat these a little bit more, and I've had to hold off eating this last pack. I've had to be strong-willed not to do that. The penultimate crisp is the Nando's Peri Peri Chicken Flavour Crisp. I was wondering what they've called it there. I am a big Nando's fan, as you can probably imagine most people of my age are. I have had Nando's crisps before. Nando's had their own branded crisps, not with Walkers. They were disappointing. And the packaging on this is also disappointing. So it's actually the only one, I think. I mean, Yo has a little bit of branding there. It has multiple colorations. Also some branding here. I like the effort that's been made, but it's a bit washed out. It isn't jumping out at me. I also, Nando's has nice packaging on its takeaways, and I'm not really getting that here. So the Nando's font and the bird here, they could have made more of that in the packaging, in my opinion. There's nice touches, and it's going to score a 3.5 on the packaging, but it could have been a 4, a 4.5 if they'd really put more effort in here. Let's get the tear. That was one of the nicer tears, actually. This packet has held up well. Inspection of the crisp, that was nicely rolled up. Sorry, didn't take a smell. It smells of peri-peri, but it's not strong. And when we get into it, it's a very disappointing crisp. Very, very disappointing. So it's like a Nando's plain chicken. It's barely even medium. There's no spice there. I want some spice for my peri-peri. But also there's just not much flavor. It could be so much more flavor in here. It's like you've taken some roast chicken crisps, withdrawn some of the flavor, and added a tiny bit of spice. They're getting a 2 on the flavor. The aftertaste is okay, they get a 3 on that. But the crisp experience, because of the hype and because of the letdown, is a 1. These are a real bottom tier crisp in my opinion. Last but not least, we have Yo Sushi Katsu Curry. Now, Yo Sushi Katsu Curry is very, very nice. I would have preferred if it was avocado katsu curry. I really love an avocado katsu curry. However, this will do. Katsu curry is delicious. I love a katsu curry. Would have preferred, again, a spicy katsu curry. That does pique my interest a little bit more, but I actually really like the packaging here. So orange is a color we don't really see as much in crisps anymore. So roast chicken crisps used to be a real staple flavor, and they have drifted away as we have these different variations of chicken and other brands bring out better chicken crisps than Walker's roast chicken. It's nice to bring orange back. There's a little bit of contrast with the crisp and there's a little bit of detailing here. I'm gonna give this a 3 on the packaging. It's not quite as nice as the Nando's one with the variations, but I think Yo has less of a brand to work with. It's also interesting that Yo Sushi haven't gone for a sushi flavored crisp. They've gone for the katsu curry. Let's give this a rip and see what it feels like. Ooh, that was an unsatisfying rip. It was almost too tightly packaged. Hopefully that's kept some freshness and already I can get a whiff of the katsu curry. Come on, here, let's dive in. Ooh, yeah. It's interesting. I'd say it smells more like fish and chip shop curry sauce than a traditional katsu curry. However, there's definitely some katsu in there. Let's have a look at the crisp. Very plain crisp. Thought they might have had a bit more spice on there. This is what I've noticed throughout the week. All the flavour is in the dust. The crisp is nice. The dust is very nice. It tastes like katsu curry, a little bit watered down, but it's a nice crisp. The aftertaste is also nice. It actually feels like you've eaten a katsu curry, but it all comes from the dust. That's great. But if you were someone who, you know, uses their tongue a lot after the bite, the crisp loses a lot of flavor instantly, and then you're chewing on something that's much less flavorful. If you eat crisps like a normal person, just chewing them, then there'll be no issues at all. And Pringles have a very similar problem with some of the stronger flavored ones where the dust carries a lot of the flavor. I've got these 4 on the flavor and 4 on the aftertaste. These are a strong crisp in my opinion. And as for such, they score high on the crisp experience. So there isn't much hype about these crisps for me. That kind of caps out their crisp experience. So with the Nando's crisps, it's like, oh my god, I'm eating a Nando's crisp. Yo Sushi doesn't have that brand power for me, but what it does have is a very, very nice crisp. One that I would go back and eat again, and it scores a 3.5 out of 5 on the crisp experience. So there we go. I've tried all the crisps, and you can see the leaderboard either to my left or my right, depending on where I edit it. However, the winner to me was unanimous and it was clear, and it is the katsu curry crisp. This is an interesting choice of flavour. We haven't really seen much in this way before, and I'm really pleased and actually proud of Walkers for how they've delivered on this. Katsu curry is a great flavour, and this is a flavour that I think should stick around and you should go out and try them. Thanks for watching, guys. I've been Tom of the Man. Remember to like the video, subscribe if you're new, and head on over to follow me on Twitter and Twitch and all those good things like Instagram.